Hello, my world. It's good again to come on in what is in the mind of God, from the heart of God. And the Lord is saying to us to watch the company we keep. Watch the company we keep. The Bible says, any one of us looking for the second coming of the Lord Jesus should purify themselves. A sign that you are waiting for the Lord Jesus is you purifying yourself. And I'm talking to those who have given their life to Christ. If you see yourself, you're not purifying yourself at this time, then there is need for check in your life. Because those who are looking for the second coming of the Lord Jesus, they purify themselves. Now, the Lord, I had to come on at this time because quickened it in my heart to speak to the body of Christ. And I'm going to take in my text from 1 Corinthians chapter 5 from verse 9. He says, I wrote to you in my epistle not to keep company with sexually immoral people. Verse 10. Yet I certainly did not mean with the sexually immoral people of this world, or with the covetous, or the extortionists, or the idolaters. Since then, you would need to go out of the world. Verse 11. But now I have written to you not to keep company with anyone named a brother who is sexually immoral, or covetous, or idolater, or reviler, or a drunkard, or extortioner, not even to eat with such a person. Verse 12. For what have I to do with judging those also who are outside? Do you not judge those who are inside? But those who are outside, God judges. Therefore, put away from yourself the evil person. Put away from yourself the evil person. Put away from yourself the evil person. What is happening in the body of Christ today? We know people who are sexually immoral. We know people who are covetous. We know people who are drunkards. They call themselves children of God. They call themselves believers. We know those who worship idols. We know those who are extortioners. And yet, because we want to have friendship, we want to have numbers. We want to have, numerical people in your church, and you keep them. The Bible says it's time you stop keeping company with evildoers. Put the evil person away. Put the evil person away. Now, the number one evil company you must not keep, as per the word of God, is those who are sexually immoral. If you know a man, if you know a woman, if you know a boy, if you know a girl, if you know a pastor, if you know a bishop, if you know whoever they call themselves that are sexually immoral, please don't keep company with them. The company you keep will either make you or mar you. The days are evil, and God is warning. Don't keep company with sexually immoral people. Sexually immoral people. Sexually immoral people. It's very important. Watch what you're doing, watch who you're keeping company with. If they are sexually immoral, a married woman sleeping with another person who is not a husband, any such things, different adultery, fornication, you know, name it. Please don't keep company with such people. Number two, covetous people. People who strongly desire to possess something, especially things that belongs to another person, is full in the church. They want to have what you have. They want to be who you are. Those are covetous people. You must not keep company with anybody you see that have a very strong desire to possess something. They want it by all means. They want it by all every means just to get that. Especially something that does not belong to them. Something that belongs to another person. If you keep company with those people, the Lord is saying, change your company. Don't keep company with covetous people. Those who are after what does not belong to them. They'll be after your husband. They'll be after your property. They'll be after your children. They'll be after your ministry. They'll be after anything you have. They'll be after it. They want to have it by all means. They want to have it by all means. Watch out. The Bible says, do not keep company with them. Number three, idolaters. Those who worship idols. There are so many people you know, they worship idols. They are your friends. And you say, they are your friends. The Bible says, don't keep company with those who worship idols. We should not have any other God but God. And the Bible teaches us that faith is the substance of things hoped for, evidence of things not seen. And faith is a currency of heaven. It's faith that we use to worship God. You don't need to bow down to any idol. You don't need to have any other God except God. Some worship chaplets, some worship stones, so many things that they have made idol. Please don't keep company. Especially when you know that people are worshiping that and you are in company with that. Evil communication corrupts good manners. Number four, a reviler. That is somebody who is always criticizing others. Somebody who is always saying unpleasant things about other people. It's all over in the body of Christ. All they do is to criticize. All they do is to be unpleasant things about people. That's all they're about. And that's whom you keep company with. You know, because you want to be in the flow of what is happening, you want to keep company with those who are always criticizing people strongly, always saying unpleasant things about people. And it's not for you to stay in that company, because before you know it, you'll become just like them. And then you have those who are drunkards. Those you know that are strongly taking alcohol. They drink alcohol. And they come to church and they say they're Christians. And they say Jesus turned water into wine. Oh, thank you. The Bible says, don't keep company with drunkards. Don't keep company with drunkards. And finally, those extortioners. These are people who obtain things by force. The people who give you threats. If you don't give it to me, I'm going to do this. If you don't do this, those don't keep company with them. Run away. Don't keep company with them. The days are evil. You need to purify yourself. You need to get rid of wrong company. Wrong company will lead you to wrong destination. There are people in the church who have made up their mind to go to hell Don't go with them. Just the way Satan has made up his mind to go, you know, he's already destined for hell. Hell is not destined for any of us. And because of that, make sure you run away. The Bible says if your finger, right finger, would lead you to hell, cut it off. That's why he has woken me up at this time to speak to the body of Christ. Please change your company. As you're going to bed and as you're waking up, I want you to think about the company. Look around. Six people that are around you. Who are they? Are they sexually immoral? Wrong. Are they idolaters? Wrong. Are they covetous people? Wrong. Are they revilers? Wrong. Are they drunkards? Wrong. Are they extortioners? Wrong. The Bible says such people, verse 13, but those who are outside God judges. Therefore, put away from yourself, put away from yourself evil person. Put away from yourself evil person. The gospel of Jesus is not a gospel of condemnation. There is still time. Grace is for us to win. Grace is not for us to lose. Grace is for us to win over sin. Jesus came and gave us grace and truth. People just talk about grace because they want to do what they want to do. Grace doesn't mean you should sin. Grace is the ability given to us not to sin, to win over situation, to win over powers of darkness, to win. That's what grace is there for. Grace and truth. He didn't give us grace and sin. He gave us grace and truth. That's why at this time, the Lord has afforded me the opportunity to speak this truth. It's very strong, but it's a truth. If Apostle Paul years ago was saying it, I am saying it again by the grace of God, that today, change your company. Change your company and see the grace of God. And peradventure your day, you're a believer, and you see yourself that you're sexually immoral, and you see yourself you're covetous, you see yourself you are an idol worshiper, you see yourself you strongly criticize people, you see yourself you're a drunkard, you take alcohol, you see yourself you are always giving threats, you are always obtaining things that are not for you, by threats, there is still opportunity for you to change. The blood of Jesus still avails for you. And the Bible says, if you confess your sins, he's faithful and just to forgive and to cleanse you. So I give you the opportunity and I ask you, just make an amendment. When you repent, God is faithful and just to forgive. But if you continue in that way, unfortunately, there is damnation. If you sow to the Spirit, you reap eternal life. If you sow to the flesh, you reap corruption. And I believe and I know the Lord has said this to deliver one man, one woman across the world from the impending danger. And I'm asking you, change your company. It might be difficult, but change your company. That's what is starting in the house of God. Judgment is starting in the house of God. Cleansing the house of God. Keep them out. If they're not ready to change, keep them out. Let them get out of the church. They can go anywhere they want to go and continue to sin. It doesn't matter. But make sure you don't keep company. You see, what is happening in the body of Christ is they do it, they do that, and everybody accommodates them. Well, it's by grace. Everybody accommodates and they think it is correct. If the church will rise up and behave in accordance to the word of God, and people who you could see sanity will come into the body of Christ. Sanity and clean and holiness, the power will return back into the body of Christ. Father, in the name of Jesus, I come to you and I believe and I know that when I call upon you, you answer me. Lord, I pray, oh God, for the body of Christ at this time. In any area, oh God, the church have been sexually immoral, I plead the blood of Jesus. forgive the body of Christ in the name of Jesus Christ. In any way, oh God the mighty, the church has become, oh God, idol worshippers. Father, forgive us in the name of Jesus. In any way, the body of Christ have become, oh God Almighty, extortioner. Lord, taking things by force and by threat. Lord, have mercy. In any way, we have revel. Any way, there have been strong criticism and saying unpleasant things about one another. Lord, I pray, let the blood cleanse us from every unrighteousness. Lord God Almighty, I believe and I know you do not send forth a word and your word will come back void. You have a plan, you have a purpose. There is a man, there's a woman across the world you want to bring out from destruction. Thank you, God. I give you praise, God, because it is done. And your name is glorified. To them who will heed the God, they will see the glory in their life. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. God bless you. This is from the heart of God. God bless you all. Amen.